I don't know.
What? I know that every day that I sit down and work at this desk and look at these screens for hours upon a time, I know that I'm not always going to have something great to show for it, no matter if I put 1 hour in or 5 hours in. It's like every time you sit down to do this work, you're never guaranteed that you're going to come out with something you're happy with. You're going to turn on the system tomorrow and listen back to what you did and just be like, wow, this sucks. I don't like it at all. And you'll scrap it. Last night I was doing some guitar riffing here and I played the same thing until 4:30 this morning and wasn't 100% sure I was satisfied with it still. And we're talking about like maybe a 5 second max fill.
Programmed some kind of like silly drums to just get me through this part to record a line.
I'm gonna try this shit.
It just a little bit. I wasn't ready for that. Let's do it again. Ah, fuck, I might be a cut here later. No. It's close. Let's try it again. I want it fucking shredded. Try it again. Oh, that might be good. I think I'm rushing it a little bit. Or let's listen to it in slow-mo. Is that fucking right? Does that snare even need to be there? Wow, I don't know. I could do it better. I could already tell I didn't like it. I didn't like that one either. We're gonna do this 5,000 times and I don't care. That one had some flair. It's just a little bit ahead of the beat, man. No, that's sloppy too. I keep messing that up. I don't know if I like it. No. Fuck. Couldn't get the vibe on. Has that ever happened to you? I don't know, it just doesn't sound right anymore to me. Man, I have a really hard time with this part.
That process is what makes you grow, because the more you do it, the better you get at it. Sucks though, because sometimes you do spend a lot of hours and you don't get anywhere. You have to learn when to walk away from it. Or maybe, you know, you are dealing with something emotionally in your life that is just not inspiring to you. So, you know, that reflects upon your creative side. And that's a fact. It can happen all the time. I just wanted to get that point across, because you're going to be a fly on the wall watching me create some stuff, and I can't guarantee it's always gonna be good. You know, I might have you, you know, be watching me create a drum part that absolutely sounds like dog shit, and that's okay, because that's just a part of the process. Because let's get the shit out of the way so we can find and get closer and quicker to the good stuff. And whether the good stuff is something maybe that someone else creates, because I just am not good enough to create that part because I'm not a drummer, or I'm not a bass player or something like that, or a keyboardist, then great. I just did the best what I could, and then that's what I love about collaborating with some other musicians. When I send a piece of music to somebody, what's really cool about it is when I get something back, whether it's a drum part or a bass line or something, it's like fucking Christmas morning. I'm anxious to hear what they're doing to it, because it always changes the music a little bit, and 99% of the time it changes it for the better. Most of the people I've chosen to work with see my vision. They hear what I'm doing and they kind of understand what I'm doing. So they take it to the next level because of their level of expertise in their own instrument. I'm gonna end up giving this track to my favorite mate, Arnaud Verrier, my drummer in France, and he's gonna go over and go, I got way better ideas than you, because you're not a drummer. And I'm gonna be like, let's hear what they are. That's what's going to happen with this music, is I'll do the best that I can at creating drums, and then I'll get it to him, and he'll be like, oh, this is fucking awesome. Or he'll recreate a bunch of stuff, however it sounds to me at the tail end of it. I'll be like, oh, okay, I like it. Or no, I like what I did better. That's the one good thing about being a one-man one-man show. You know? It's that you end up making the final decisions, which is nice. But I'm always open to someone else's idea when it comes to this. That's why I've hired so many different musicians along the way, because I know that they're going to put their ultra cool creative stamp on something that I would have never thought of. You know? So I always want to keep those options open to me. Fucking cut.